I'm Hydlide of ReasonExperts.com. Please make note, this video is for educational purposes only. Yes, that had to be said over here because I know for a fact that the track that I'm going to talk about is owned by Sony. And Sony has a thing for banning people from YouTube for posting songs that were published by Sony. Okay. Track is called this. It's The Magician from it's The Magician from Sunlight. And this track was kind of like released somewhere at the end of 2014, if I'm not mistaken. I could be. And this sounds like this. Remember the original track, by the way. Remember the original track, by the way. Wham! Come. So, why isn't this guy banned from YouTube? I don't get it, but anyways. The thing is this, is that this thing is remixed. And that original snippet is right there. And the thing that you need to know about this particular track is that the beats per minute lies around 122.1, right there. So that's the thing that I'm going to enter right there. And I'm going to move in this snippet, this audio snippet right there. And I'm going to stick in the snap to, let's say, 164th notes. Because in this case, it allows me to move the anchor pretty accurate right there. The thing that I'm going to do is use this part right there as a reference. And the thing that I want to achieve over here is to move this thing up so it follows along that line right there. So there it goes, there it goes, there it goes, there it goes, there. Kind of like that. That could work. I just zoom in over here to check if everything is in sync. Well, it's not really. It's not really. I could also snap this thing off right there and move it just a nudge right there. Thank you. Snap on and press play. Yes, 122.1 it is. That's the magical number. The next thing that I want to do over here is because it's a remix. And the thing that they kind of did was use this track, but they kind of shuffled it. So it became their own unique track. and they used this snippet to produce the original, the new file. So the thing that I'm going to do, and this is going to be a little bit trial and error over here. Yeah, you got a lot of live stuff over here. The thing that I'm going to try over here is to slice this up over here first. So I'm going to start up with the beginning, right there. I'll take the slice tool, right there, razor tool. And I'll slice that up right there. So it kind of starts at the beginning of that sound. Right there. Sounds fine. The only problem that I have right now, and this is something that I already came across with when I was a little bit experimenting before making this whole video thing, is there is a metronome being played inside of the snippet. As you can hear right here. Tick, 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 tick. But I can use that as a reference later on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Stop it right there. I'll slice this up right there. I'll slice this up right there. That's going to be part one. There. Let's continue. Yeah, boring, is it? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, this is rock and roll. Stop it right there. I'll zoom in and I'll take again the slice tool right there. Think, thank you. Now, this is just trial and error that I'm doing. It is not balls and accurate, but that's not the point. The point is this. I'll say open this track right there. Open this track right there. And the thing that I want to do over here is because I'm measuring 8 bars. So the endpoint from this sound or this song should end somewhere around there. So I'll take the control key and I'll drag this arrow towards the point where I think like, okay, this is where I have 8 bars right there. I'll just use Snap-on right there. Oops, no, we're not going to do that yet. Then we come to the next snippet, and the next snippet should start around the 9.0.0.0 marker right there. The thing that I'm just doing is entering the numbers. So if I press 2, it starts with 2, but in this case I actually want to have 1 1 1 0 1. Wait, I actually want to have 1. What? I'll just enter it right here. Double click the whole thing and I'll say 9.1.1.0. Enter. Then it starts right there at the beginning of the 9 bar marker. But in this case, I actually want to end somewhere here. That's the 70 bar marker. So I'll do the same thing with the time stretching thing. Press and hold the control key and time stretch it so it ends somewhere around the 8 bars right there. Length is now 8 bars. You could do it manually, like entering the number, but I'm just going to do that with dragging stuff. Okay, next up, we have the whole thing tempo synchronized. So I'll just see if this is going to work by using a rag right there. I'll stick in a, let's go for a drum track. Let's go for a stroll. Drum track it is. I'll take a default patch from the, where yet? Dr. Octrex loop player. This sounds now like this. Put a thing in solo right there. In this case, there is some point where it actually goes off. That's somewhere around the half right there. I could just drag this up right there. So snap the anchor point right there. So it actually becomes in sync with the rest. Still, there are little timing issues that are happening over here, but I can resolve that by manually selecting a few snippets over here and over here. This is a little bit time consuming process to do it like this, because it's basically going to be a house track. And that's the thing with this particular track, at least the remix that is that I'm just going to create a few snippets over here where these things are anchored more or less and based on the tempo of 122.1 beats per minute. I'll say right click and then say bounce clip to max loop right there. So I have my max loop right there. I'll delete this file. Bye. You can go bye. I'll do the same thing with the first segment over here. I'm just going to do 2 of these. Right there. Over here, same issue. I mean, it's like if they actually recorded this being off beat for some reason. So I'll just do the same thing with this one. I'll just move that up right here. I'll just move this up right there. And I'll just move this up right there. This is just a part where it kind of feels like it's going like weird. Same thing can be said for that one. But the rest, it still plays along with the beat. Fine by me. I'll say right click, bounce, open the file right there. So I right click and then bounce rex to loop right there. Oops. What's happening over here? Yeah. I'll say right click and then bounce rex to clip to max loop right there. Now I have my second loop right there. Now for the fun part. Open up the file right there and then go back to my rack. Where's my rack? Rack there. And I'll say copy loop to track. Copy loop to track right there. Disable the playback mode right there. Go back to the sequencer. Oops, I actually have 2 of them. Oh, me bad. But like I've said, this original track or that remix track basically mangles the complete song in a different direction, more or less. It just takes certain sound snippets and then turns it into something new. But that's kind of like the cool thing with the setup, because I have slices. I can rearrange the slices if I want to. So in a way, I could, let's say I have the first name. I can just delete these notes right there. And I'll say copy paste. So I actually have the same snippet from the beginning, and I'll take that two times. Why not? It's an option to do so, because it's a remix, right? Okay, here goes. That sounds like this. And if I want to go really creative over here, I mean, we're just creating a remix, right? Okay, let's go for this route. I'll take these notes and I'll make that stutter thing effect, kind of like something like that. Could work. I'm not sure. I'll just see. That's that note right there. Okay, let's go for that route. I'll go for delete these notes. I'll select this note right there. That's the piano thing. That's that one right there. I'll keep that right there, and I'll draw on a note like that. So it becomes like a really long note. The only thing that I'm using right now is a pencil tool to draw in that note. I can just select it over there, pencil tool, and I'll say, let's draw it in here, right there. And I'll press a mouse tool, and I'll drag it on top of the first bar where I want it to be, like right there. I'll delete these notes because I don't want the whole thing to be overlapping with the rest. And I can repeat this sequence. And in this case, I'm actually going to go for that stutter effect, more or less. I have no idea how this is going to sound like. But this is just trial and error that I'm doing. And I'll drag it somewhere like this, like that. That's going to be two 16th notes, if I'm not mistaken. It's four 16th notes even. Four 16th notes. And then take one four 16th notes. And then take 4/16th note. That's a quarter note. It's the same thing as a quarter note. Yeah, there you go. One quarter note. Yay, one quarter note. I'll just do this like this, and then repeat the sequence over 1/16th notes again. This sounds like this right now. It's a little bit weird, but then again, this is my take on it. I like weird stuff. So that's my first snippet. I'll just double click it right here. I create a new sequencer track right there with using a Dr. X file. I'll go back to the Reason Rec. Where's Reason Rec? Reason Rec. Where? Yeah, there you are. In this case, I can just open it up right there. Say copy label and loop to track, and I'll disable the playback mode right there. So I have the same thing with the slices. I'll just put this thing in solo. I'll just mute the other ones right there. I'll just keep the drum track, that one. And I'll say, I'll just delete these notes right there, because that's kind of like a glitchy sound effect. Right there. In this case, I could do something creative over here. I mean, why not? I could go for this note. Take these notes out right there, and I'll just do let's do it like this. I'll go for this route. I'll select this note right there, and then that note right there, and I'll just duplicate this note right there, and this is just random stuff that I'm doing, just like this, and see how this works. That doesn't work at all. I'll just shorten this clip right there, shorten this clip right there, and shorten this clip right there. I'll just do the same thing with this one. Shorten this clip, shorten this clip, shorten this clip. And in this case, I actually have my original take on how that thing would normally sound like. So again, I can just repeat the sequence right there, copy paste right there. move this up, just like that. And take this whole shabam out right from here, right there. That note can go by. In that case, I can just use this as a sequence, like this, like that, delete the sequence, and I can just copy and paste the whole thing again. Let's go for a bar. I like bars. Right there, right there, and use this as a track. Again, the thing that I could do next is, because it's a sample thing, I can start adding insert effects on top of this whole thing, where I think like, okay, what does it need? Does it need reverb? Does it need some space over left and right? Does it need some bandpass filtering? Yeah, sure. Bandpass filtering sounds like a cool idea. I'm going to go for an instrument that's going to be a maelstrom, and I'm going to stick that as a inside of a insert effect. I'll say right click, reset device, and I'll spread this up right there, and I'll select over here this one inside of the main input, the main input right there. That thing can go in the main input, and that thing can go from the main output inside of the insert effect. Go back to the front, press tab, and I'll select over here a bandpass filter, and have the frequencies adjusted a little bit differently over here. I'll turn oscillator A off. Not that's being used, but I'll just do that for the safe side, for being on the safe side. And that sounds like this. I can fine tune the setting over here. Make it bright. But because there's a lot of stuttering things coming through, I could also apply a reverb effect on top of this thing to diminish the fact that the whole thing is actually stopping. So in this case, I'll just go for something really simple. I'll take a RV7 half rack device, put the thing on hold. That basically diminishes that stuttering effect more or less, or that stopping effect. But if you want to go for that approach, yeah, sure, it's an option to do so. Next thing that I could do is replace this original track from the acoustic drums, because I was just using this as a reference. Delete all in group. And the next thing that I could do is let's take a let's go creative on this whole shebang while I'm on the topic. This is the part that I hate about Reason 8. Why are you constantly flip-flopping back and forth to the sequencer? Stop doing that. Hey, cool, glitches. The thing that I'm going to do next, that's loading up some samples over. Let's go for kit drums. Kong kits, Kong patches, Kong sound samples, bass drums. I'll go for my lovely tone cone here. There you are. Thanks. Yeah, sounds fine. This disco kit can go as well. I'll select over here factory sound bank. That's going to be a well, let's go for a treasure. Treasure this snare drum, and then select over here snare drum treasure. Way in treasure, because it's a saturated there. I'll go for the XTC4. Why not? It's a nice sample. I'll take this a couple of times, 1, 2, 3, right there, and I'll shorten this up right there, so this becomes the short hi-hat right there, this becomes the longer hi-hat right there, and this is going to be my open hi-hat. So in this case, I can already start creating a new complete house track from this whole thing by loading up a redrum pattern like 1, 5, 9 and 13 on the bass drum, and go for the straightforward approach on 5 and 13 for the snare. Take the hi-hat session over here, and I'm going to go for a three-stepper. That's 1, 4, 7, and then 9, 12, and then 15. And I'll take the open hi-hat in between on every bar. That's 3, 4, 3, 7, 11, 15. And then this whole thing goes in between some parts where I think, okay, this needs some added syncopation parts. right there. That's 2 and 5. I'll go for 10 and 13, right there. This thing there. I'll just shorten it up just a little bit, pitch it down just a little bit, pitch it up a little bit. There, sounds fine with me. Right click, copy pattern to track. Enable pattern goes off. And of course, I could go really wacky on this whole matter. It kind of depends on what you're trying to aim over here. I mean, that's the nasty part with creating a remix like this. Do you want to stick with the original sequence, or do you want to layer the original sequence on top of the new version, or do you want to create your own unique version like I'm doing right here? That all depends. The only thing that's really important about this whole setup is, if you're going to time it right, make use of this tempo synchronized, this tempo 122.1. That's the most important part. Another piece of advice over here, I would load up this track first and then later on bring the second one. That's the O'Caroline thing. Because if you're going to do that, it makes it easier for you to mix up the O'Caroline song with this one. If you do it the other way around, then it's going to be a really nasty part, because it has everything to do with the way that the whole thing is being loaded up. You need to time stretch it again, etc., etc., and that can become a little bit messy. Hopefully this is useful. I have no idea. Anyways, have lots of fun, and I will talk to you later.